doing is arming civilians. You are not there, so you cannot see. He didn't answer. So then after that, I said, Reuters today, in Reuters, you must know that there is a man who was appointed by CNT for the manhunt to Gaddafi. There is a coordinator of the manhunt. We are really in the far west. And this man is called Mohajar. He said, we think that Gaddafi is in Iraq because NATO bombed a lot of Iraq. So I asked NATO, it seems that CNT is saying that you are really helping them in doing this manhunt, which is forbidden by the United Nations Security Council resolution, because you are not supposed to do manhunt and regime change. He said, he didn't answer in this point. He just said, all what we are bombing is civilian target, and because they are threatening civilians.
You know, you become cynical after a while and just expect these people to lie and to kill.
But
But
at the
I
same
want to I'd like to ask you, you're quite well known for organizing demonstrations, and I saw your manifesto and you took photographs. Is this not the best answer, the best solution, that people go out onto the street and do something?
Yes, so for that. This time people didn't go out to the street much, like say the case of Italy. If you see the polls, I think 70% of Italians are against this war. But as we don't have a democratic government, it seems they are not listened to. But this time they don't go out really, and we are small groups. We did a lot of activities. The pictures you saw are about the last days, but it's been since March. We are doing also activities in the streets, but we are small groups. In the other wars, and maximum in the 2003 war, really, there were millions in the streets on 18th of February 2003. It was not useful because the war went on, but it is worse not to do. It is worse not to go to the streets. And this time, myself also, I committed against this war. I gave more time against this war, even if you compare to the other wars, you see. But at the same time, I went less in the streets, and as you told me on email, we did more computer work. We tried very much to convince everybody to show the lies. We exchange a lot of information, and why about the causes, and about what is happening, and about why, but the point is that we are not enough powerful to break the big media, to reach the big media. So we should go more in the streets. Maybe in a way which is powerful, even if we are not many. And I have an idea on that. But go on.
No, I think if you tell us your idea, I have a question, but then we will leave the subject. I'm really curious if there is Israeli influence in Italy on the military operations, on its foreign policy. I mean, America and the United Kingdom is very well known for being Zionist controlled, basically. Is it the same in Italy?
I think Italy is more American controlled. And it is well known that if the United States had not put their military equipment and knowledge and expertise there, this war could not happen. I mean, there was in the last, say, all the former wars, the Americans were always there. Maybe France was not there, like in 2003. Others were not there. Arab countries were not there or were there, but the Americans were always there, and the UK, of course, another colony, and Italy, another colony. So I think we are more influenced by that. Then, who is influencing America? It's a big question, and I don't want to go into that. I am not an expert on that.
So tell me, this is our first interview. You've been marvelous. I won't edit it at all. Have you anything to finish with to say to
Yeah,
anybody?
I want to ask everybody if they think it could be a good idea, because now, of course, there is this war is has gone for a long time, but still, the Security Council is supposed to meet again because the NATO mandate is over on within few days, maybe within 2 weeks. I have to check.
19.
But and there are 12 members in the Security Council who don't participate to this war. Three members participate: France, UK, and USA. The others don't participate. There are African countries, Russia, China, Latin American, but Brazil, for instance, Asian countries, very powerful like India. What we did as a small Italian group, we tried to make like an emailing appeal to this Security Council non-belligerent members. We tried since June, we have been trying, but we didn't have a big answer from the people who were supposed to send these emails. By the way, if you want, I can give you the website from where you can download this. It's www.peaceandjustice, all the same, dot IT, like Italy, slash Libya with the Y, the second is Y, Libya, dot PHP. From
Okay.
there we can download this appeal to non-belligerent Security Council members. I think they only can stop these NATO operations and show the truth. And for that, maybe we have a few days to organize in all the cities, even if we are only three in every city, it's not a matter. We have to organize meetings, take pictures, and these happenings, like even 2 hours, with the same message: stop Libya war, stop NATO war in Libya, and maybe having a banner or a symbol like, let's say, a red umbrella or black umbrella, saying who will protect the civilians from NATO, which is bombing all the time. Like having a common, something in common in many cities, in many countries, and then centralize the pictures of this and send these pictures to embassies and to the Security Council members and to the media. Yeah, and to politicians.
I will put it in the description as well. People can find it in the description of this video.
Thank you.
I think I just wonder what is final. But I think things, events are so volatile at this moment, this evening, the next few hours, the next day or two in Libya. I think they know very well that the council resolution will expire soon, and they're trying to finish everything now. And you were right to bring up Fallujah, and maybe that's how we end this interview by mentioning the threat of Fallujah happening again.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.